If you notice me using these, I don't know if I've talked about them before. They're very useful, very handy. You get little blocks of sandpaper with them, and if you can't find yours, if yours has gone missing, I use emery boards from the pound shop. They're really good because you can just get them, put them in your pencil case, and they work just as well. Right, mouths. Now I've picked some different mouths because the two we used in class were very obviously pouty mouths. Even though one of them was a male mouth, it was still quite pillowy. But these ones are going to be for older people because not everybody is young and pouty. Just so you can get the shapes and also a little bit of expression in a couple of them. These photographs are absolutely fantastic. I mean, the Pinterest has really come on in the last year or two for artists' reference photographs. And if you're ever stuck for anything to do, these are just lovely. This photograph's really interesting. And photographs of older people are always more interesting anyway. You can obviously see the planes of the face and you can really make out things like the eyes with the eye sockets. If you look at the way he's lit from above and to the front. He's not lit from the side, but the sides of his face are slightly in shadow and his neck is in shadow. But you can really see the planes of his face, and it's so much harder to do that with a young face. So even though we use those reference photos for the big pillowy mouth, just to give you a feel of how to create a mouth, I thought I'd vary it up and let you feel what it was like to draw older mouths. So this one is still quite easy because it's straight across. So you draw a centre line, middle. I can't decide where I want it. Now these corners are very important because, you know, just a slight change in these corners and it changes the whole expression of the person, and that will change the whole face. You don't think that the corners of the mouth are that important. They really, really are. Lots of people always say about the eyes and how important the eyes are, and that's quite obvious. You're always going to focus on the eyes, but the expression of the mouth is so important. Very hard thing to get right for a lot of people as well, me included. His lips are quite pursed, and how, you know, if we were to really go into this, how you would show that as an expression are actually the muscles around the mouth. If you look at the underneath this bit's in shadow, and there's his chin, it's on an angle. Already I'm thinking I've done it too big. That's okay, it's charcoal, you just rub it out and move it. It's hard to draw something in isolation, just the mouth, without everything around it, because it doesn't look right. These are just face lines, they're not. Now it's this little thing here, this shadow. This is a muscle underneath your lip, all the muscles around your lips. And he's sort of tightened and pursed. I mean, what would you say his expression is? tense. I don't know. Doesn't look relaxed, that's for sure. Top of his nose. Don't shade across like this because it's a big space and you just want to fill it. Go with the lines, direction of the skin. This part of the mouth usually pops out over the bottom lip. Now, there's something when you, I was talking as well in class about not doing outlines, trying your best not to do them. It's something called lost and found edges. You see it in a lot of landscape drawing as well. You don't need to mark the edges a lot. Now, if you look at his bottom lip here on the photograph, it's very similar half tones or mid tones. So if you were to put a big outline there, it would just look very wrong. It would stand out. Now there is a nice little section here that's a little bit darker, but that still needs rubbing in. But not everything needs to be defined. Not everything needs an obvious edge to it. We say, well, it's the edge of the mouth, so we need to see it. Well, no, if it's hinted at, it can be a lot more effective than hammering it home with a big line. I put lines in at the beginning just to show where everything needs to be for me to see it. Then it's a series of putting things in, taking things out, wiping things away. Thank you. Sometimes it's only when I get everything that's around it in the right place that things start to pop out. It gives you context as well. You know how deep certain shades should go. If everything was white around it, it'd be hard to judge. If it's just the plain paper.
Is there warm water?
Put the heat on. Well, I just got the message saying I've got a low battery, so I don't know how long I've got. So I'm going to have to speed this up. I'm getting far too carried away. Enjoying myself. These lovely reference photos, they really are good.
Thank you.
Right, I'm going to stop there on that one. Highlights in and here. No, I'm gonna keep going. I don't think that shadow comes down that far. I'm going to step back and look at it. And there is a light section over here. Very dark. I need an edge for this.